Welcome back to the PopcornFX channel for a new tutorial. This one will help you easily integrate PopcornFX in Unity and to configure these two programs in the optimum way to fulfill your needs. Alright, let's start by creating a folder and name it Unity next to your PopcornFX project. Open Unity and create a new project in the folder we just created. After that, we'll need to import the PopcornFX plugin to Unity by double-clicking on the package. Wait for it to load. Then we'll create a folder named StreamingAssets in the root of the Unity folder. It's case-sensitive, by the way. And then we'll enter that folder and create another folder named PackFx, which is also case-sensitive. Now that that's done, we'll open the PopcornFX editor, select our project, and click on Settings. And then verify that the axis system in the Scene tab corresponds to Unity's, which is axis left hand Y up. And you can also refer to the axis system independent Quick Tips tutorial to adapt your effect. Next, we'll go to the Baking section by clicking on the Baking tab. And we'll add a new entry called Unity. The easiest way to do this now is to go back to the subfolder PackFX and the Streaming Assets folder. And copy the path of the project starting from Unity. And pass that path in the baking section in the project baking settings, without deleting the first two dots. Then, we'll click on OK, and open the popcorn project. Over here, we'll right-click an effect that we already made, and select Bake. Check all the options, and click OK. After that, we'll have the effect in Unity in the PackFX Particles folder. It's now time to test this effect in the Unity engine. To do that, we'll first have to add a script called PKFX Rendering plugin to the camera. Then we'll edit the settings by checking Has Post Effects, which is recommended to check by default. It's usually used if you're having issues with the post effect. Then let's check Show Advanced Settings and enable soft particles, which lets us have a nice soft transition between the particle and the 3D environment. And let's not forget to enable distortion in case we were using shaders for distortion. Next, we'll put the rendering path to deferred and check the camera's HDR option for better reaction to the glow of the post effect. Now we'll add a new game object. Add a component and look for the PKFX effects to add it to it. Then we'll select or drag and drop our effect to the script. We'll notice that the attributes of the effect will appear, if the effect has any, of course. And now we'll run the scene with the play button. But we'll notice that something doesn't look right. The colors do not match with the popcorn editor, and that's because Unity is using gamma correction. So if we want the colors to match those of the editor, we'll need to deactivate the gamma correction in Unity. We'll do that by pressing Ctrl-Shift-B to open Build Settings, then Player Settings and Other Settings, and change the color space from gamma to linear. And then we'll play the scene to see the results. And there you go, the rendering now matches Popcorn's rendering. Well, this wraps up our tutorial. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more useful videos. Thank you for watching.